Indigner House is proud to present Reflections of Me by Dr. Davida Hammond. This is a personal memoir of how she overcame her fear giant and tore down her fear wall in order to become successful in life. And she takes us by the hand as God took her by the hand to help her walk the steps and do what she needed to do to grow and empower herself. Every woman needs to read this book. Please enjoy chapter 1 of Reflections of Me. It wasn't so much that the fear wall existed, but that I carried a fear brick with me everywhere. Dr. Davida Hammond. One, conquering fear into the light. For God hath not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. 2 Timothy 1:7. When I finally found the courage to leave, I left afraid. I wasn't smart. I wasn't pretty. I had no strength. Devalued, degraded, destroyed. I possessed no sense of self, no sense of purpose, no sense of hope, no sense of anything other than the vapid observation that, oh, I'm breathing. I walked each day with 2 young children and 0 effort remaining to deposit into my tumulus 5-year marriage. Therefore, I packed our clothes and called for a U-Haul. I knew I was leaving for the final time, and not like the other times before. Never again would I step foot into that house with that man, the man I gave a pledge to, and the man who fathered my babies. I remained in my failed marriage to afford my children a family similar to the one I enjoyed growing up. However, instead of a loving and nurturing relationship between 2 adults, my marriage was a dark void that required me to sleep night after night in a bed that had become my personal legacy to endure, actually to survive, or so I thought. One day I looked at my children, really looked at my children. It was then that I realized my marriage didn't just impact me, it affected them too. My children deserved a life without hate, a life without regret. It was my job as a mother to teach my son that it was not okay for a man to mistreat a woman. And if necessary, I had to find a way to give my daughter the courage to walk away from an abusive relationship. They were the reasons I remained so long, and now they were the reason I had to leave. I was ill-equipped and unprepared for such a drastic change. And it was only through God's good grace that I caught a small glimpse of an inner power that I never knew existed. Unveiling this hidden power felt more like I was releasing a pressure-driven crack, something I could not easily control. The more I coaxed that crack to widen, the more my power flowed into reality, and the more I appreciated it. As the energy bubbled from somewhere deep inside, I was reminded of lava that simmered deeply inside a volcano. Would I blow apart and melt into the earth, or would I grow into a towering strength? I did not know that answer. It wasn't a feeling of chaos exactly, nor was it a feeling of catastrophe. It was a strength unlike anything I had ever experienced. Despite a palpable lack of supportive rationality and contrary to what I'd been told for years about my worthless self, I felt empowered. For the first time, I felt in control of my life, my destiny. The veil was lifted, and I was left with an acceptance and understanding that was invigorating. I was smart, I was beautiful, and I was worthy. There was more to life than simply existing and acting within the constraints of how others viewed me. I was made for something important, something proficient and worthy. God had created me with a purpose, although I had not yet heard God's calling. I did feel a slight tug once, actually more of an angelic nudge, so I trusted it. Even if only just long enough to do what I had to do, I remained firm, snuggled within my newly found power. as I packed and taped the boxes. I had much to do and much farther to go, and this was just the beginning, a baby step into my future. It was a new world, my world. That was 30-some years ago, and I have never looked back. Well, maybe just a little. And when I left afraid.